Hi everyone, I'm Marco Brigham and welcome to Python for NMA Part 1. During this workshop, you learn about basic Python for NMA tutorials, where you learn to do a few things, apply them well and often. So basically, you will learn a few tools and a few ways of using those tools, and the purpose is for you to use them again and again. Now, we'll cover basic Python, the LIF neuron, and how to structure your code. Part 1, part of this video, you'll see the first two, basic Python and LIF neuron. And in part 2, we'll continue with the LIF neuron and you'll learn to structure your code. Okay, let's get started with part 1. Earlier on I mentioned LIF neuron, but what is it? Well, it's a neuron model. It's a simplified version of neurons, but that capture their behavior. Now, an LIF neuron is indeed a very simplified model, which is the one that we're representing on the right. It doesn't model any physical aspects of the neuron in terms of morphology, but it does model some very interesting things. LIF stands for leaky, integrate, and fire. And basically, this neuron, it models the membrane potential voltage. It has a leak term, and it can spike. So we'll go more into detail a little bit on about each one of these aspects. And now we switch to Python. Let's go to Python basics. We'll cover variables, control flow, plotting, and NumPy. Starting with variables, they are a bit like name tags that you can use to label your data. For example, let's say you had some images. You could call your variable images and store the images there. Or if you had some spiking data, some traces, you could store them on a variable called spikes. And if you had some logging data from some device, you could store it in a variable called log. Now, Python names, variable names, they have some rules. So they have to start with capital A to capital Z, lowercase a to lowercase z, or an underscore. And they may include digits, such as from 0 to 9. So here below you have two examples of variables and their values. Now, variable names in Python are case sensitive. Lowercase neuron is a different variable from uppercase neuron. And there are some reserved names, such as import, lambda, if, true, and a few others. You learn by using them later on. Let's start about numbers. Now, numbers in Python, they come as integers that have the types int and long. You have two examples here. With the one with a very long number is the type long. The first one is type int. You have real and complex numbers, represented by the types float and complex. The first example is the real number 1. Second example is a very small number that is represented in exponential notation. And the third example, C, is a complex number. Let's talk about operations with numbers. So we have addition and subtraction, where we just use the plus and minus sign, as expected. Multiplication and division, so we multiply with the asterisk. And here, I need to tell you something about division. So the two numbers in this division here, they are ints, they're integers. But the result is a float. And this is because in Python 3, division of integers is always a float. Now you can have a power of a number with a double asterisk, just here, and you can have the modulo operation with this symbol here, which gives you the remainder from the integer division. So the integer division, 14 by 3 is 12, and then you have the remainder, which is 2. Okay, so some things we have to be aware about numbers and operations. One of them is type change, also known as casting. So here we multiply two integers and the result is an integer. But here we multiply an int by a float and the result is a float. Now let's talk about strings. Strings is how we represent text in Python with a type str. So here I'm assigning the string hello world to the variable a. And the print command enables us to print strings. So here I use the print command to print my string. The print command can accept also several variables to be printed. So here I'm printing two variables, and when you print them, then the result is called a concatenation of both variables and a little space between them. Now in Python, you can represent quotes in two ways, single quote and double quote, they're equivalent. And this is how you would mix quotes. So the quote that is representing your string is the outer one, and then you put the others on the interior, but of a different type. So if your string, you're representing it with a double quote, then you can have a single quote inside and vice versa. You can also have strings that cover several lines. This is the one example, and in this case you use three single quotes at the beginning and at the end of your string. Now let's talk about formatting strings. So since Python 3.6, f-strings were adopted, and this is a very flexible way to print your variables. So f-strings, you start by writing an f, and then your quotation mark, and then these curly marks, and inside you put your variables. So my string a is printed here in this position, we have a space here, and my string b is printed here. Of course it becomes more interesting when you have to print and format, for example, numbers. The example on top, we have a number with several decimal points, and let's say we want to represent just three decimal points as a float. So we put this colon dot 3f. It represents these three decimal points here. So my variable x was truncated to three decimal points. And if I would like to have it represented in exponential notation with four decimal points, then I put a 4 here, and I switch my f to an e. Constants. Now in Python, we have booleans, represented by the type bool. And, well, booleans are true or false. And you invert the type by using not. So if it is true, it becomes false. If it was false, it becomes true. Then we have also a constant to represent the absence of something, and this is the none type. We'll learn a bit more about none type later on. Now let's talk about commas and line breaks. So you use the comma symbol to start your comma that you can put on the same level as your line, you can put above your line typically, and say a little hint about what the command is doing or the operations that come next are doing. You can also comment with multi-line strings. Okay, now let's talk about the membrane equation. So earlier on, we saw that the LIF neuron has models voltage in time, and this is represented by this equation right here that is called the membrane equation. Okay, let's break it down. So on the left side we have the time evolution of Vt, our membrane potential or the voltage of the neuron. So the time evolution of Vt is given by the right side of this equation, namely the synaptic input and a leak term. Synaptic input is the input to the neuron, and the leak term is a mechanism that makes the Vt go to a rest value if no further input arrives. Otherwise, if the neuron received some input, some synaptic input, and was at a certain voltage level, without the leak term, it would stay there. But this way, it just goes down to the rest value. So this is our membrane equation. Okay, so let's get started with coding. Please head back to the tutorial notebook from this lecture, so tutorial 1, and go to exercises 1, 2, and 3, where you will encode the simulation parameters, you will print, you will implement and print synaptic input, and then practice with print formatting.